So yesterday I was telling you about conversion routine, right? Then compounding we saw. Then what else did we do? We created info objects, right? Did we create the data source?
Yes.
Okay. Data source we created, we saw the preview. Then the next step would be, can you tell me what would be the next step?
Or the I'm not sure we created an info object, or info package.
We have done all that. The next
Okay.
step in the modeling would be create DSO.
Yeah, right. We did the trans okay, yeah. Transformation.
So we have a DSO. We have to create DSO. Right click, create data store object.
Yeah, Arvind, just a quick question.
So we said that we have to place the objects. Yes.
Yeah, I was trying to practice yesterday class, but I wasn't maintaining my codes in the sheet that you provided. So
Okay.
is it better, like we should do it first in Excel and then kind of do this practice, right? So that you won't miss the
I cannot understand.
Z course. I was using the Z course. I was creating myself. And
Okay.
I was adding a Z after whatever you mentioned in the Excel in the Excel sheet. So, and I missed kind of updating the Excel with my course, what I was doing. So,
Okay.
yeah, just wanted to comment that, it's better to kind of do it in Excel, like what I wanted to create, and then create it, in this, so that you
Yes.
won't miss it, right?
So we have a key field and a data field. So how do you decide? Since it is a file scenario, yeah, usually it will be the primary key of the table, but since it is a file scenario, discuss with the user, make him understand the property. In this case, I will be taking company code. You can take anything you wish. I am taking company code. maximum how many key fields can be there? There should be a limit, 16.
Why is the limit?
Based on performance reasons.
Okay.
There should be a good design if you can't keep on adding all the key fields into the DBS. That's why they have restricted it.
You mentioned 16, right? 16.
Yes.
Okay.
So I have put company code in key fields. What about the other fields? Other.
It goes to data field.
Correct.
So there is any limit for data field?
No. Always cross check whether you have added everything from the file or not. Everything is there. Now activate. At this moment, all the tables in DSO will be generated. Activation queue, active data, and change log.
So, Arvind, when we created a DSO, this was a standard DSO, right?
Correct. So DSO means normal DSO. If someone is using general DSO, that implies that it's a standard DSO.
How we check from the screen you have?
What kind of? Yeah, that's what I'm telling you. In the settings, here you have option, which says standard DSO.
Okay.
So if you want to specifically create other type of DSO, you have to choose it over here.
Okay. So when you were actually creating it, we did not get the option for pick on it, right? So this is after you created it, you change it?
Correct. No. I'm saying if you want to create any DSO, you have to begin like this. But if you want to create specifically, you change this, then you activate.
Right, okay. That's what I'm saying. So after you...
Yeah, for example, if I have to create another type of DSO called write optimized DSO. I should begin in the same way. I create the DSO in the same way. Then, before adding the fields, first I should come over here and then I have to
change before the type. Before you add the field, you need to change.
Yeah, in the initial stage itself, the moment I start beginning, I have to change the type, then I have to add the fields. What all tables got created, you can see in this symbol I. Dictionary status. Currently no data exists. You have an active table. So active table will be slash BAC slash A DSO name and 00. Activation key will queue will be 40. Change log some random name. So all the table names you can see over here, if you double click, it will take you to the table as well, where you can go and see the output if data is there. Last, who changed it, those things you can see. Here again, you can see who changed last. Activation logs. What happened during the activation? The tables got generated. Here you have info provider properties. Okay, so it tells how the data is read during query. There are three modes, A, X and H. Which is better according to you?
One was the blank one, right?
So the three modes, which is better?
I would say two.
Query to read data during navigation. In that case, it will be reading all the data during navigation.
Yeah, H would H be
ideal, because whatever you are navigating, like from material you are going to material type, it pulls only material type. Then you are going to material group, it pulls only material group. So that's how the default info, it is the read mode. So whatever query is created on this will be having the same option, that everything will behave in this way.
So this is the default.
Can you come again?
That's it. The option you just picked, that was the default?
Yeah,
Setting
that's the
was
default
the
option. And whatever queries created on top of this will use the same option. So your object is created. Now the next step, create and execute info package. Did I upload in server yesterday? Yeah, we uploaded, right? Create info package.
So we did not load it to the PS or PSP.
Yeah, now I have run info package, it will get loaded. So four records got loaded. The next step will be transformation. Check and then activate.
So this is the automatically done the transformation?
Yeah. Can you tell me the reason why?
I think we picked yesterday, I remember. Or is maps automatically? I don't recall this.
Correct. Yeah, so the reason is in the data source under fields we assigned the corresponding info objects.
Right, right, yesterday.
Yeah, we typed it, yeah.
So info object, yeah. So this properties got mapped to the field. So indirectly you are mapping both objects of the same type. So that's how the mapping is coming on.
Oh, okay, from here, yeah, right.
Then you have to run the DTP. This naming convention you should remember. For transformation you can see it is RSDS. RSDS means four letter word code for data source. Then source system, then a DSO, four letter code for DSO, then the DSO name. This is how the name will be, but technical name randomly generated.
So RSDS will always be there, RSDS, that's the way we start always.
Yeah, yeah. If you are linking from data source to DSO. Between DSO to DSO, it would be ODSO and ODSO.
Okay. Here, RS means for random source.
system internal naming convention. This is the table, TADIR, directory of all repository objects. In that table, this is the field object. Here you can see the four letter word for everything. For report, it will be REP or like that. Why it is not showing entire thing is the limited output it has got 500 entries. From outside, if you see over here, you can find it. Sorted it. Okay, so for data source it is RSTS. For transformation, will be another thing. Or DSO it will be. For multi-provider MPRO. for DSO it is ODSO. So this is the place you can comment, cross check. If you have the four letter word, what it make, what it is, you can find over here. So the transformation description will be of this format: technical name, system generated. Then DTP. It will be just data, what is the source, source system, target. By knowing this naming conventions, you can easily distinguish when you are, when you have multiple sources and targets. So first which table the data has come, to always expand and see.
Active queue.
Yes, tell me. Correct. So whenever the DTP is running, it executes in one particular sequence. Let us see that particular sequence. First it extracts, then it filters out, then the logic will be applied, and finally data will be updated. You can see the TTP main screen, first extraction, then filtering. If suppose I am getting lot of data from the source system, every day full load for example, or whatever data might come, whether a full load or a delta load, but further target, I want to load only particular data. Like for example, we are getting so many company codes data. I just want to update only company code 2000. So my PSA will contain all the data. My DTP while executing, it will filter only 2000 related company code data and send it upwards. That kind of things you can put it in the DTP filter over here. Okay. It's ideal not to get everything while extracting from source system. You have a selection option wherein you can selectively bring from source system. Okay, let us see that. Here, whenever I am extracting from source system. In info package data selection tab, I have an option to selectively extract, but that field should be selected. You can do like this. I'll change data source. Fields. Selection. Possible or not, we have to choose. So selection is possible. What kind of selections you want to do? Whether it is equal to one particular value, two values, like that. Then you activate it. So whenever you are dealing with a custom data source, you are the one who is going to specify it. I mean to say file data source, you are the one who can specify that option. That will automatically reflect in the info package selection screen. Some changes happening, right? So that's why it has to modify the structures. It's taking time. Okay. What it has given in the message, data transfer process is locked by user BWPI. So you might be thinking we are changing the data source, but why DTP is also linked to it? What happens if we are working with the DTP, right? So the issue is data source means whenever you are modifying a source or a target, the transformation link will be disturbed. When transformation is becoming deactive, it will try to deactivate DTP. But I was locking the DTP, so it was unable to perform its functional. That's why it could not activate. Now I have come out of it. Let us activate it. You can see data source activated. Now you check the info package. Is reflecting, right? So this is how you can selectively load from source system at info package level if you are unable to do that, or if you want all data but further while updating to target you want only limited data, then in the DTP you can do the filtering. So whenever that happens, it processes in the below way. First it extracts all the data, then whatever DTP filter is there that it will apply, it pulls only that data, then out of that data any similar keys are there it will filter out, then the logic will be applied and it will be finally updated to the target. Okay. Coming back, I just want to go back to my last load. I have an option over here, last request. It takes me to the last load. Go to the administer data target. So currently, as you said, it is in the queue. Then let me open the table / BSE / A 00. This the active table. Four zero will be the activation queue. So in activation queue data is there, number of records will be 4. The queue is maintained due to the concept of this request ID. Whichever is coming earlier, that would be activated first. Then you go to the active data table. Do you have any data in active table now? It will be 0. In change log, the number of entries is 0. So what should I do now? You know, currently for the characteristic values, our SID is generated. They are not generated.
Yeah,
they will be generated during activation. So I have to activate it. Select this, activate. Select it, activate. So during activation, what is happening? Data is moving from activation queue to active data and change log. At the same time, SIDs are generated for characteristic values. Whatever values are being activated, SIDs are being generated. You click on refresh, you will see a reporting symbol availability. So until and unless I activate the data, it is not available for reporting. Once it successfully completes, then it is available. In a DSO, whenever you see yellow symbol, that means without the reporting symbol and only yellow symbol, that means load is running. Yellow symbol with reporting symbol means activation is running. You can place cursor and find out what exactly is happening, whether load is happening or activation is running. So now activation completed. There would have been a corresponding job for it. This was the job name. It starts with BIODSA. Today, the job started. All data fields updated in mode overwrite. What does this mean? Whatever data fields are there, everything will be overwritten if the key field combination is same. You can see SID determination finished. So SID is being generated during activation. For all characteristic values, SIDs will be generated. You can see. Now in the activation queue, do you have any data?
No.
It becomes black. In the active data, how many records you are expecting?
4, right?
We loaded 4 records. We are expecting 4 records. In the change log?
Same 4.
Same 4. But what's the difference between active data and change log? In change log, zero record mode is there where it maintains all the images along with some information about the request through which it got loaded. So what is the record mode for all of them? They are loaded for first time. So everyone is the image is N. So this is how it happens. So initial, when you run DTP, a request ID is there, 84. That corresponds to this one, DTPR. It's a normal thing. After activation, this request ID no longer exists. You'll have a new request ID generated upon activation. That 85 corresponds to this one, ODSR, and this information. So after activation, it's identified by that request ID. You can see the activation log over here. What happened? You can see. So the loading time is 6 seconds, but activation time you can find over here. If I click on main process, it says activation started at 7 and ended at 44. So 37 seconds it took for activation runtime. During activation, what happened? SID generation happened for all the characteristic values. So you can select like this, click on contents. This also shows you the data in the DSO, but click on field selection. By default it chooses only couple of fields. If you want to see all the fields from DSO, select all, execute, and by default it shows only 200 records. In real world you will be dealing with thousands of records, so if you want to see entire data, give a bigger number over there. In our case only 4 records, so it doesn't matter. So 4 records it is showing. So I am seeing this output means it's nothing but it's indirectly showing me from the active table. If I want to see how many records came, I can click output number of hits. So if I say sum it up, it shows me total how many records are there in my DSO. So this is about the DSO thing. Now let us what I would do is I would load another file with the same data. What would happen in that case? If I am loading the same data back to the DSO, what are you expecting? Will it cause any impact?
You mean exact same data?
Yeah, exact same data.
It will overwrite.
Okay.
Or
like, will the data in my target change because of this similar load?
No, it will be the same file in the
No, I think the target will change. Yes. Because we'll double the value.
Okay, but what is the property of DSO? Whenever key field is same, it will overwrite.
No.
But while loading, it will see 1000 already exists or not. If it exists, it will overwrite.
Overwrite, yeah.
So in case of a DSO, can I say that we can blindly do reloads?
Yeah.
Because anyhow, it's going to overwrite.
Overwrite, yeah.
Okay. And do you expect any change in the change log table? Will any entries be added to change log because of this similar
load? Change log. Yeah, change log will have a minus entry, right?
But in this case, it doesn't happen like this. Whenever you are loading a similar record, not much happens in the change log.
Okay.
It.
So only when you saying when it's changed, then we'll you know have a change.
Yeah.
But otherwise, if you're
specifically,
loading the same thing.
Okay.
Yeah, like specifically if any variation is there, like in any plant account or any balance, in that case, it means overwriting, but in our case it's just loading the same data, right? Okay. It's not overwriting as such in our case, it's just leaving it aside. So you can see that can I retrieve the same PSA request with the same DTP, delta DTP, or I cannot retrieve it? Again, I already posted it.
Retrieving meaning, I don't understand. Is it?
From PSA, can I post to the target the same request again?
Yes, we can, I guess. Because nothing is changing, right?
And okay, let us see that. If I run delta DTP now, so you are expecting it to pick the same four records from PSA.
So is it, this is a delta, so
delta DTP.
So his delta will not change anything, right?
Yeah. Justify your answer. In what context are you asking? So my question is, can I pull the same PSA request again? That's my question. Are you also on the same page?
Right.
Okay, so what's your answer? Can I pull it again?
Yes.
Yes, it looks like, yeah.
Says no more data available. What happens when you run delta DTP? It will check whether the PSA has been updated or not.
Oh.
Whatever is unupdated, new PSA it will bring.
Okay.
Clear?
Clear, yeah.
So, in order to achieve this scenario of a duplicate load or a same double load, I can't run the same DTP. I have to achieve it through another DTP, that is the full DTP. Using full DTP, can I extract it again and again?
Yes, in that case, yes.
Always, whenever you are doing any full DTP or any full info package, you have to clearly specify so that others will understand that it's meant for specific purpose. And by default, the update mode will be delta. You have to put it to full. System will not allow you to create two delta DTPs. You can see. And I am trying to create a similar delta DTP. System says that there is already one more delta DTP, right? Overlapping selection criteria. Obviously, in an ideal scenario, would you like to maintain two types of delta or a single delta?
Single delta, I think.
Single delta. That's why system doesn't allow you. You can further read by this message. While you do the practice. So there can't be two delta DTPs, but there can be many full DTPs.
Okay.
I'll create this delta full DTP. We'll continue the discussion tomorrow.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Baba.